My name is Kenny. Welcome to another exciting moment at Anstar Rock Crusher. This shrub is very nice and cozy and warm to wear in all kinds of weather, especially in winter. So, very easy to make. You just need few crochet skills and you'll be good to go. I used a very fluffy poodle yarn, but for you to see the stitches, I will start with this type of yarn. Make a slip knot. And chain how wide you want your shrug to be. You can chain and wrap around your widest part of your chest. Into each chain stitches, make single crochets. Carry on making single crochets for two rows. I am working into the back loop. This makes a neater edging. Turn and make second row of your single crochet. This is how it will be looking so far. 10. For the third row, chain 2 counts as your first double crochet. Into each single crochet, make a double crochet down this row. Coming to the end of the third row, make a double crochet, turn your work, and that's how it will be looking so far. Make 2 chain stitches for your first double crochet. Go around the first post of your double crochet and make a front post double crochet, and go around the back of your next double crochet and make back post double crochet. Alternate between front post and back post double crochets for 10 rows. This is a very simple stitch to use to make the shrug, and anyone can master it in no time at all. So carry on with your length. And that's how it will be looking so far. 10. 2 chains count as the first double crochet. Chain 2 count as the first double crochet. And carry on repeating your front post. Where you have your front post double crochet, you make a front post double crochet and back post double crochet around the next. After 10 rows of front post and back post double crochet, this is how the lovely pattern will be looking like. Repeat row 1 and 2 by making single crochets for the next 2 rows. The pattern is so easy now. All you have to do is to repeat your 10 rows of front post and back post double crochet. So you make a complete row of double crochet, turn over, and then you start your front post and back post double crochets. And you grow and make your shrug as long as you want it to be, and you'll be looking something like this. It's quite big to fit into the camera, so let's see. So after 10 rows, you see the dip in the 2 rows of single crochets. Fold in half and we're creating the armholes area. Measure about 6 inches, that's where the armhole will be, and sew the sides up to where your armhole will be, your 6 inches. Use any sewing method that you're comfortable with. Here on As The Row Crochet, you can find the seaming method using the crochet hook or the whip stitch, or any method you quite comfortable with. Make sure you join and sew both sides of your shrug together. And that's how it will be looking like the armhole. That's the wrong side. It's hardly noticeable, but I do. Now fold your shrug in such format, and we'll be elongating the bottom part of our shrug. So you can try it on to see how it fits, and then use a yarn marker to mark where you'll be attaching your length. This will cover the lower part of your back side. We're going to carry on making the same pattern as we did in the main part of the shrug. So attach your yarn and make a roll of double crochets. coming to the end of that row, we're making our double crochets. So when you get to the end of this row, you turn your shrug and carry on with the pattern of your front post, back post double crochets. And when you have enough length, finish with two rows of single crochets. You can take off your yarn marker at this point. It makes it easier to carry on with your pattern. So we're gonna turn. And we'll make two chain stitches that count as the first double crochet. Front post double crochets around the next and back post double crochet around the other double crochet, and we repeat. And this is how it is looking so far. We're going to work around the sides of the shrug. We start from the one corner and we go all the way around to the top and back to the other corner. We'll be making single crochets into and all the way around. When you finish, you turn and you make your back post single crochets to make a rib effect of single crochets. So we'll be making single crochet ribbing all the way around to hem the shrug nicely. The yarn is a little bit fuzzy, so it might be a bit difficult for you to notice the stitch pattern at times, but it's quite obvious when you put the garment on. So carry on all the way around, going around the top and to the other side. That's the top, and to the other side all the way down till you get to the corner on that side. That's the other side and that's the corner. Yeah. So once you have the required length, you still carry on making your single crochets, but now into the top of the back loop, just like so, to make a ribbon effect. We'll be making the cuffs for the shrugs. This is a chunky yarn, so I'll be chaining 12 chain stitches. You can chain longer or shorter depending on how long or how short you want your cuffs to be for your shrug. And once you finish your number of rows, I've got 12 chain stitches into the back loops. I'll be making single crochets. And once you finish this row, turn your work and make the single crochet ribbon. You can follow a much detailed tutorial on how to make the single crochet ribbon here on Nancy-Darrell Crochet. Click the description box or the information bar. Make a single crochet into the first single crochet, and now we'll be working into the back loops, making single crochets for the ribbon effect. Make this as long as it wraps around your arm and you're comfortable with it. And this is it. So join together and seam your cuff. Once the cuff is done, you need to attach it to the main body of your shrug or garment in the armhole. You can use a yarn marker to secure temporarily the corner of your cuff to the shrug. And all we have to do is just sew it all the way around. And that is it. Well done for making another garment. And enjoy your shrug. It is very warm and cozy. Attach the yarn and then just sew. Remember, you can sew with either or any method that you're comfortable with. You can use a yarn needle or your crochet hook. It's up to you. You are the designer also, because you're making it. So the most important thing is for you to enjoy whatever you're making. We thank you so much for tuning in to another exciting episode of Ask the Raw Crochet. Thank you for your love over the years, and thank you for subscribing to this channel. If you haven't done so, you will see a subscribe button in the middle. Feel free to press the subscribe button and enjoy the next videos in the boxes below. Thank you and God bless.